Hello guys and welcome back. In today's video we'll be talking about my last day for Hezonja challenge. So first off, let's go here. So I fed my Okmin and recently I pulled a Cinda. It's like 3 or 4 hours ago. I also pulled a Lam in meantime. But I fed him immediately because, yeah. So yeah, and there I fed both Fiona and Schilder because I didn't need them. And other than that, I fed Okmin as well. So I only left Thanatos for PvP and Ascindo also for PvP and campaign, and that's it. And Elec, of course, but Elec is not that great, or at least not unless he is E2 or plus. So yeah, this is my stats on Holder: 25k attack, a little bit of speed, and I'm running him in double leech set, so leech set and fearless set for more leech and mastery and little bit of crit rate, so he can sustain when he has counter attack up on him. Then here I got some crit rate, attack damage, yada yada yada, attack effect hit. So yeah, that's all right. And then this is my tank hero, or rather shielder and healer. So I decided to go for Olivia. It's first time I ever used her. She's okay, like she's not god tier like Anton or Vim, but she's still decent. So she has attack down on her basic, then increases all life speed and turn meter, and then additional increases by 8%. So 8, 10, so it's 20%. Meter increase, which is decent. Then here she grants ally protection with ally with lowest HP, then restores some percentage of HP, and then her ultimate increases all allies defense by 30%, and shield equal to 20% max HP. Olivia's max HP, and then once she's exclusive level 3, increases defense by 60%. So yeah, those are her stats. It's HP and speed is all you need. Then Ascindo, she is there to help with waves, so she keeps them CC'd, or rather silence them, so they cannot use active skills, so only basic. Then we have Anton for shielding and healing, and we have Yar for cleanse, because he is cleansing 3 layers of dot. Then he's kinda like him low key, so he increases his own turn meter when she's getting, or rather taking damage. Then shield, and then the shield will increase to 40% once he is E3. And he got low chance to freeze someone, but it can come in handy. And yeah, before I started recording, I pulled this guy. He seems, he's not that great, but he seems interesting. Reducing their turn meter, then dealing some damage, then dealing damage, and then increases that damage based on layer of buffs the target has. So yeah, here I didn't really farm because I didn't have time, so I cleared stage 16 here, and I haven't even touched other dungeon. Then I did a little bit of farming for Neja, only stage 7, stage 11 here, and only stage 9 in Marius. Then Sanctuary is only like 2 A5 heroes and 1 A1, so a little bit of stats, nothing huge. Then talents, I focused always on Force Mark because I have Holder and Anton, and I had Okmin. So that's that. Then PvP, I didn't really focus that much. I didn't focus on PvP at all. What else? Guild boss. Let's go to level 3. I can. Well, since I had Okmin, I will not deal any damage, but I don't care. So yeah, 5 million damage almost. So it is decent. It is decent. I'm missing. So it's here. I mean, it's decent for 6 day actually. Old account is decent, or even I think 5 days. We'll check now how. When is it? So yeah, six days old account. Other than that, not really. I have a couple of these, couple of those. Nothing special here. And yeah, I'm currently on Hell 510, and I don't have time. Like, I will need to farm Olivia's last artifact. Then I would need to farm faster gear for Ascindo and better gear for Holder, but I do not have time for that. So yeah, officially I have failed challenge as free to play. So there is that. I got like epic eye from here, and I made Holder E3, but again, better stats, better gear on him. So yeah. So yeah, pretty much that's it. Here, nothing special. I haven't done anything. I barely touched dungeons, so all I was doing is focusing on the campaign, and I was spending all my gems on summons. And yeah, I'm close to pity, but it will not happen, and it's time to retire this account. Yeah, that was it, guys. So maybe in future, when I will have like 7 days off or something, I will maybe try again. But like, I can play for 2 days, then 2 days I cannot play for because I'm at work and I'm going to work, and then I will not be able to play today anymore and tomorrow. And that's when this challenge ends. So I will be able to play like after this challenge ends. So yeah, kind of unlucky, but it was a fun. It was a fun back to time when I first time started and cleared my campaign, and it took me so much longer on my main account when I first time started. I had no idea what I was doing. Or anything. I remember I built HAL 9000 as a DPS, and then I pulled Serena after him. Then I started building Serena, but I was stuck on campaign for like 2 months or even more back then. But back then it was much harder to clear campaign. Nowadays it's so easy. So yeah, guys, thank you for watching, and see you in the next one.